aliens or higher dimensional gods may have helped measure, design, and create the holographic universe as we know it. A striking and unusual mathematical grid pattern covers the globe, a pattern involving the extraordinary value of pi and the golden ratio.
An irrational number is a number that cannot be divided. According to Pythagoras scholars, all of creation is numbers. Therefore, the existence of an irrational number makes for quite a controversy.
Prepare yourself for a higher order of conspiracy with interface to God. The best-known goals of the alchemists were the transmutation of common metals into gold or silver. Less well-known is plant alchemy and the creation of a panacea, a remedy that supposedly would cure all diseases and prolong life indefinitely, and the discovery of a universal solvent. Although these were not the only uses for the science, they were the ones most documented and well-known. Starting with the Middle Ages, European alchemists invested much effort on the search for the Philosopher's Stone, a legendary substance that was believed to be an essential ingredient for either or both of those goals. The Philosopher's Stone was believed to mystically amplify the user's knowledge of alchemy so much that anything was attainable. The Pythagorean cult believed that reality is mathematical in nature and at its deepest level, that philosophy can be used for spiritual purification, that the soul can thereby rise to union with the divine, that certain symbols have a mystical significance, and that all brothers of an order should observe strict loyalty and secrecy. The cubic Ark of the Covenant, the Moldavite-infused black meteorite that hundreds of thousands of devout believers circle as an act of genuflection and interface to God.
Architects for Dionysus, so they were called. It was believed that King Solomon hired them to rebuild his temple. They were mystics, worshippers of the god Dionysus, who passed on their knowledge through secret ceremonies. Secret ceremonies and mathematics. There exists a key which connects these two.
Ironically, this may hold the secrets of the Philosopher's Stone, for within the atomic element of certain space metals and stardust is the very geometry and interwebbing of what the holographic universe is composed of. We lack the knowledge on how to extract it completely, but we catch glimpses of it on LSD and DMT, and when physicists shoot protons at neutrons so fast that it approaches the speed of light, a realm of unbelievable discovery is just around the corner. The supple gleaming presence of the snake, her midnight-colored glistening thin coil, observed this morning near the sun-glazed lake, unnerves Pythagoras. His daily toil of studying birds, winged geometries, the way they intersect with wind and light, originating angles with the trees, is halted by this primitive black sight. But intellect soon subjugates his fear. He pauses patient, hoping for a move, expressing undulation. Now a pair of hungry hawks is circling right above. He warns the hunted snake, and off he goes. The way late sunshine glances off these stones, caressing granite with its western light, and whispering affection to earth's bones with radiant bronze lust that would invite. Hot rapture in the living soothes him now, as if he'll be beloved even when his flesh declines to dust, as if somehow the sun can feel a passion for old men through all the darkness of eternity. A supernatural sky sheathing stone beneath time God's grant with those of grace, embeds his sign in the spiritual language of spoken love and the electrical expressway of the obedient divinity to become inspired and find the muse. The soul was not then imprisoned in a gross mortal body as it is now. It was united to a luminous, heavenly, ethereal body, which served it as a vehicle to fly through the air, rise to the stars, and wander over all the regions of immensity. Then first I felt my wings wave into immortality and flew across the ocean with a shouting host of thunders at my heels, and lit up heaven and earth and the sea, and one quick lamp and crowned the mountains with a momentary gold, and covered them with blackness. Then I glanced upon the mighty city in her sleep, pierced all her mysteries with one swift look, then bade my thunder shout. The city trembled, and charmed with sublime outcry, I paused and listened, yet had I rised and learned a loftier lesson, I was lifted high into the heavens, and there became a star. Humility is glory, self alone is base, and pride is pain, patience is power, beneficence is bliss, and now first brought to know myself and feel my littleness, I was to learn what greatness is prepared for virtuous souls, what mighty war they wage, what vast impossibilities come, what kingdoms and institute of love and harmony and never-ending joy, and converse and communion with the great and glorious mind unknown, are given to the high and godlike souls. Always seek the mysteries, my friends, but eat the sun and your tongue will be burned from the taste.
The number in my head is the true name of God.
Yes, it's the key to the messianic age. It can take us one step closer to the Garden of Eden. As the Romans burned the temple, the Talmud tells us the high priest walked into the flames. He took the key to the top of the burning building. The heavens opened and received the key from the priest's outstretched hand.
We have been looking for that key ever since. And you may have found it. Is it God?
No, you are not pure. You cannot see God unless you are pure.
I saw everything.
You saw nothing, only a glimpse.
So much more.
We can use the key to unlock the door. We can show God we are pure again. He will return.
You're not pure. How are you pure? I found it.
I think you are. You are only a vessel from our God. You are carrying a delivery that was meant for us!
It was given to me! It's inside of me! It's changing me!
It's killing you! Because you are not ready to receive it!
It's just a number. I'm sure you've written down every 216-digit number. You've translated all of them. Intoned them all, haven't you? What's it gotten you? The number is nothing. It's the meaning, the syntax. It's between the numbers. If you haven't understood it, it's because it's not for you.